What up, heads? So, what do you do with all your old tapes? Much like me, you probably have many of them. That's about 325 tapes right there. What I want to do is put them all underneath of this glass table. Now, I don't use this table very much anymore because it's a computer table. It came from an old business I had, and everything's on a laptop now, so I don't need the undersides, the drawer, the tower stand, or any of this shit anymore. So, what I want to do is take all these tapes and put them underneath of there, much like those six, but the whole entire bottom of this glass right underneath, all set up on a shelf. And you can do this with an old table if you want. Paint a thrift store table as long as it's got a good piece of glass. I'll kind of show you how to put a little support underneath it, and you can display all your amazing tapes because I don't play them anymore, but I certainly don't want to get rid of them because it's all my memories are right there. I wrote all those. I grabbed all those L sleeves, all those tape cards. So anyway, let's go from there and see how it comes out. All right. You can do this too. All right, heads, check it out. I got the glass off and I separated the two sides, this side over here and that side over there. And basically, all I did was move the sliding tray for my old keyboard all the way over to the left and put a couple holes over there and attach that same piece, that thing right there, in. And then I put a board, if you can see it right there, underneath all the tapes. So I managed to get 286 tapes onto here. I'm going to put the glass back on it, and all my tapes will be nice and set up. Now, they are certainly not in order at all, and I'm going to put them in order, and I'm not going to bother having you guys watch me put them in order, obviously. But what I am going to do is I'm going to take that coin right there, and I'm going to spin it. And for the rest of the video, we're going to listen to whatever show it lands on because they're all mixed up right now. So I'm going to do that from back here, and I'll be right back. All right, let's do a little spin of the coin, see what show we get to listen to. All right, it's spinning not too bad. It's wiggling around a little bit. What are we on? Oh, Winterland, 12/31/71. That's going to be killer. All right, that's what we'll listen to. All right, heads. What to do with your old tapes? Do something like this. Let's listen to Bill Graham for a second. The coin we spun. 12/31/71, Winterland. So this is that. Let's listen to it for a minute. Fantastic stuff.
For what we have here. Once again, for your pleasure and mine, the Grateful Dead.
It was fun spinning the coin across the tapes. They're all in order now. Nice and secure. I even got a little trivet for my beer so I don't make a water stain on the new glass. Well, old glass. Because it is old glass. I bought this for a job, like I said earlier. Man, I had two of them. 25, 28 years ago.
Chicago, New York, Detroit, and
as I mentioned before, no one uses a tower slide out keyboard tray. Expanded it, put a board under it, put all the tapes in, put these little front things on. I'll later paint these, but it's like 14 degrees out here, so I'm not painting shit right now. But it came out good, and you can do this with a bunch of your old tapes under something like this, or a thrift store table that has glass on it, and you can paint it any kind of cool color you want and build a little under shelf. I mean, this was pretty damn easy, you know? I didn't have to put a lot into it. Some measurements, some cutting, basic shit, you know? But the tapes that I'm not going to play anymore because they're available everywhere, of course. Online, if any. I'm not going to get a cassette player. Some of my good friends, like my friend Jeff from my book, he still plays his tapes and still does some trading, but I think it's more like the aesthetic, having the old tape, you know. For me, I didn't want to get rid of them. What do you do with them, you know? Like, I'm not going to sell them. I'm not going to run out and buy a really nice cassette player to preserve the tape quality, because everybody else has them, but I still want them. I still want to keep them. It's part of everything that we've all done, Grateful Dead-wise, especially when I was a young deadhead. My tapes were everything to me, and probably to you as well. So. We should take a look.
I'm out of there. I'm out of there.
Alright. I start over here, and my first tape was in 69, of course, that I got, or the first, some of the first tapes I got were super early, but I put them in order, is what I actually mean. So it goes up this way, and then all the way back down. And I just kind of do them all in chronological order. So everything is the way that the years went, and much more towards this end is where I have a lot of the tapes and the shows that I went to that I got from my friend Farrell, who was a taper, and I would just record the tapes when we got back home. So anyway, super easy. Cut up some old, an old wood trivet, like that you put hot pots on, that we were getting rid of, and made little fronts for it. Had to put some little spacers in between there, where the metal bars were, and I also left the back of the desk, so it could still be a desk. So alright, well, I'm gonna try and stick this back in here without disrupting too much, and we'll listen to the rest of Truckin'. But yeah, you can do this with your tapes and with your stuff. I mean, if you're gonna keep them, why keep them in a closet or in a drawer? You know, some people display them in the cassette racks that they used to have, and that's great. I love that. I just didn't know what to do with this old desk besides use the top as a desk. You know, the underside is just for my feet, basically now. So, anyway, do something with your tapes. Grab a cheap old desk or modify one you got. Coffee table that is glass. Do it up. Paint it. Make it look cool. Make it your own. Because you made your tapes your own. And that was huge. All these, every sleeve that you made, everything that you drew, all the ones you printed or made up your own, they're all still there. Put them on order, display them, and every time you're doing something, you get to remember them. That's what I love about it. Grateful Dead is just, you know, fuck. Like, our own super awesome version of Memory Lane. Yeah. Yeah. Anyway. Cheers, everybody. Make your tapes your own and thank a taper. We would have none of this without them. Thank you, Farrell. Thank you, everyone who recorded these. go from there, you guys. Talk to you.